missiles in a fight. Possessing superb maneuverability, exceptional reliability, and a multitude of advanced combat systems, the F/A-18 is the world's premier carrier-based strike fighter. The F/A-18 first saw combat action in April 1986 in the Hornets and USS Coleman Sea Mark on suppression of enemy air defense missions against Libyan air defenses as an integral part of Operation El Dorado. Since then, the F/A-18 has been at the forefront of the war on terrorism, including and currently today, Operation Inherent Resolve, projecting combat power from the sea day or night. This highly versatile combat-proven strike fighter, paired with highly trained pilots and weapons systems operators like the ones bringing you today's fleet air power demonstration, make this platform among the most feared in the world.
Thank you so much for having us out. Thank you to AS Oceana for all the great support every year. It's great to be with you once again. We would like to dedicate today's performance to our United States service men and women. Their selfless sacrifices to assure our freedom do not go unnoticed. Now, this jet you saw, we call that Bandy 1. It's a special jet. We will talk about that in just a minute. Let me tell you about the person flying it. That is Lieutenant Commander Mark Burgess. His call sign is Crunchy. He's U.S. Navy retired. He spent his entire career flying the F-14 Tomcat. He even did a whole lot of air show demos in that aircraft right here at NAS Oceana. Kind of makes him a little bit of a local legend, at least in his own mind, right?
To make that clear in his own mind,
that's
yes.
Right, exactly. But he's got 3,600 flying hours to back it up, 530 aircraft carrier landings, and countless air shows, and he's going to put that beautiful jet in the Warrior Parking. Really thank you for today.
This airplane, it's not an American-built airplane, but some people like to call it a Cold War trophy.
Absolutely, that's a Czechoslovakian no-trainer and a light attack aircraft called an L-39. It's an Albatross. That's good for us.
Yeah, it is considered to be the most widely used jet trainer in existence. Even greater than the T-38 Talon flown by the Air Force.
That's right, and for our purposes it's perfect because as you can notice, unlike our Hornet friends who were just out here, it's not that loud of an airplane, so we keep it showing close, and it's not going to drown out the narration, which everybody knows you really come to an air show for the narrator, obviously, so I particularly like it as well.
With a top speed of over 550 miles an hour, it has a lot of get up and go, doesn't it, Dagwood?
It does, and he's put it through paces real well. What he's doing now is called a Cuban 8. Now, what he's going to do is a little special. He's drawing the figure 8 way on the side, and you'll see he's bringing up the backside of that. But he's throwing a couple rolls on the down line. Watch what he does as he pulls over the top. He's taking that 500 miles an hour. He's kind of shrinking that airspeed for altitude, pulling back, looking over his head, on the top of his head. So that horizon as he spots it, he's going to come back down towards the ground, roll it a couple times for you. I asked him, why do you roll three times? He said, because it's more fun.
And that is exactly what Bill Left did in his Texan trainer earlier this morning. But when you do a roll in the Texan trainer, it curls around a lot more. No, you don't have to worry about that torque of V-factor and all those other parts of the energy, because all that thrust is center line.
That's almost too easy.
Is it really? Is it really easy to roll the airplane? Pretty easy just to fly. It's very basic, as you said. It's why we use trainer aircraft, also a light attack aircraft. You can put orbits underneath the wings and on the hard points. And it's a very basic jet to fly. It's perfect for what we do on the airship circuit.
All right, now my friends, the Warrior Flight Team is not just an air show team. We are a 501c3 non-profit organization. We're flying to all volunteers headquartered in Clinton Barrels. Our air show team are going across the country, raising awareness to our goal, which is to ensure this generation of veterans is honored for their service and receives career opportunities through our Wings of Opportunities program. Along with our generous sponsors from Alpha Industries, we make veterans' dreams a reality. Walk Crunchy, reposition Bandy 1 aircraft back in from the right. Go ahead and give a big wave to the air power demonstration aviators coming back by. Loud jets, they may not be able to hear you, but they can sure see you later.
This is an amazing jet. It was used by the Soviet bloc up until the collapse of the Soviet Union. And when that happened, some enterprising Americans found that some were available on the surplus market. They bought a bunch of them for 70 grand or so.
Absolutely. Look what the tells them now. You'll see them across the airfield serving quite a bit.
There are about 200 in the up there in the United States flying around. Tuck under brake the way it is, because he rolls one way, and after three quarters of that roll, he stops and then just pulls. So it looks like he's going to go one way, and he actually does the opposite.
Exactly, a right roll for a left turn. It just doesn't really make sense until you think about it a little.
But that's good in combat, right? It's deceptive if you got somebody on your tail.
Absolutely. Now, if you or someone you know is a veteran interested in the aviation base career, we'd love to meet you and let you know what we offer as a charity. Because although we may look and act like a regular airship team at our foundation, we are a charity dedicated to bettering the lives of men and women who sacrifice so much for our nation. Please check us out at warriorflightcharity.org and also check out our wonderful sponsor at alphaindustries.com. Big thanks to NA Associates for having us out once again. It's kind of become a hometown stop for us, Rob. It's something we look forward to every year, and it just never disappoints us, for sure.
Thank you, Doug Woodley. Dagwood, the Warrior Flight Team, let's give a nice round of applause. And Crunchy Burgess.